I'm Dr. Sanjay Gupta, and this is CNN.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jim Sciutto. Welcome to a special edition of Newsroom, and thanks so much for joining me. Today, the world celebrates a New Year's Eve like never before, bringing in 2021, thankfully, you might say, under the shadow, though, of the coronavirus, with scaled-down celebrations and limited gatherings. And in the final days of what has been a trying year at times, the nation is still setting alarming new pandemic records almost every day. For a second day in a row, the nation reported a record number of COVID deaths and hospitalizations on Wednesday. But as this nation suffers, President Trump seems to be paying little attention. Instead, he remains locked in on his election loss, still refuting the facts, the results, pushing baseless lies, and they are lies, about election fraud that have already been proven false. President Trump is even leaving his Florida vacation early, departing before his annual New Year's party at Mar-a-Lago, where guests have already started arriving. He's returning to D.C. early, not to address the pandemic, not to address the slow rollout of the vaccine, not to address increasing tensions with Iran, but to be back well ahead of January 6th, the day that Congress will certify Joe Biden's win, despite a Republican plan to challenge Biden's victory, disrupt what is a ceremonial process. CNN's Boris Sanchez is in West Palm Beach, where President Trump is leaving any minute. Boris, what more can you tell us about the president's plans to leave early? There's certainly a lot on his plate as president, but that doesn't seem to be his focus.
Yeah, Jim, we haven't gotten a clear response from the White House as to why the president is leaving West Palm.